Hey everyone, how's it going? In this video, we're going to take a look at something very simple, yet very effective, and something that almost everybody, including professional photographers, are accustomed to, and that is adding watermarks to your photos so that they are yours and copyrighted so that nobody else can steal it, play around with it online, et cetera, et cetera. So let's go take a look at how we can add our watermark in Zoner Photo Studio X. Okay, so as I mentioned, we use watermarks as a way to protect our photos. And besides just a general one, we can use a logo or some kind of signature to protect and copyright our work. And this is how we're going to add a watermark using Zoner Photo Studio X. Today, we're gonna use the batch filter to add watermarks to our photos. And right now I'm in the manager module and I have my folder open here with photos that I want to watermark. I'm gonna use Control A to select all the photos. Then I'm gonna go to edit and select the batch filter. I'm gonna add the text filter to my photos and I'll write my signature in this box. I'll choose my font, change the text color if you want. And I recommend using a neutral color like white or black. It's a color that stands out and is legible. So using a color that actually would stand out differently might, you know, something that's very colorful could actually take attention away from the photo and just be obnoxious and intrusive. So it's better to use something simple and easy on the eyes like black and white. And this is where we now choose where the watermark is actually going to be placed. I'm going to choose the bottom right corner. All right, now I got two options. The first option is to check use as a watermark, which gives the text a slight shadow from our light source. And I can adjust the angle of our light source right here with this wheel. And my second option is to not check this box and instead only lower the transparency. So I'm gonna set it to 70 so that my signature is there, but just really subtle. Doesn't ruin the photo or detract attention from what's going on in the photo. And finally, I click apply to all. And now I've got my photos and all of them contain our watermark or my signature. And if you wanna add a logo or an image instead of text, just go to edit, choose the batch filter and select overlay image. Click select image to add your logo. And this time I'm going to add my logo in the bottom left corner. Here you can see it's very tall, so I'm going to lower the vertical offset here. Now this time I'm going to add the logo as a watermark and set the transparency to 30%. And we're done. I can click apply to all. And with the batch filter, applying this filter might take a moment depending on the number of photos that you're applying this watermark effect to. And if you only want to add the watermark to one particular photo, click edit, then select text or image overlay. And here you can see that you don't even have the option to apply to all. All right, and that's all for me from this really simple, straightforward video. I hope it just makes things a little bit more easier, a little toolbox into your toolkit and something that you can use again and again. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe bell so you don't miss any new videos coming out from us. And I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Take care.